Kate. Kate.
I'm up here, Tony.
I'm coming home, Kate.
Oh, Tony, you shouldn't have done it.
You got my letter, then?
Of course I did, silly. How else would I be here? Oh, Tony, you'll get us both in such trouble. Father will kill you.
I don't care. You've no idea how bloody it is at school.
Come on, get up.
You've got to go back, Tony. You've got to.
I could go to sea, get a job on a ship.
Don't be silly. You'd hate that more than school. It's after two. Go back now before it gets light. They won't even know you did it. I know best, Tony. I really do. Trust me.
All right. Goodbye, Kate.
Goodbye.
Good morning, Mr. Allen.
Good morning, Miss Ferrant. Well, gentlemen, shall we begin?
Gentlemen, Herr Kroger's asked me to apologize for his being unable to attend this meeting. But he and I have discussed the agenda fully, and I have complete authority in his absence.
May I?
Please.
You're here on holiday, then?
Of course. Aren't you?
Well, not exactly. I'm sort of passing through on my way home. Been working out east, you know. Well, actually, I just drop up here to say hello to my sister. She's with Krogs.
Tony?
Kate!
Oh, it's you. It's really you.
Well, of course it is. You look prettier than ever. Look, I'd like you to meet... Well, I'm blessed.
Never mind, Tony. I won't always be able to get rid of them as easily as that.
Let's sit here.
Was it hot in Hong Kong? You look so well.
Oh, waiter. Yes, I was going to tell you about the Hong Kong job. You see, the boss...
You packed it in. You resigned.
Well, it wasn't quite like that.
Don't I know it?
And you really enjoy working in Germany?
Yes, I do. I have to go back tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh, Kate, what a rotten shame. I was hoping we could have 2 or 3 days together here before I go back to England.
You don't have to go back to England, Tony. You could come with me to Germany.
Germany?
Yes, Eric knows all about it. I think he could find you a job.
What's he like? Is he a nice chap?
You couldn't call him nice, exactly.
He's got the cash, though, isn't he?
Oh, yes.
And there'd be pickings for yours truly.
Yes, I should think so.
It'd be a bit like sponging, though, wouldn't it? You know, Kate, I've never sponged. Besides, I can't speak the lingo. I'd be no use to Crow.
Then what will you do?
Oh, something will turn up. I might get a job here.
Tony, there wouldn't be a future.
Kate, you know as well as I haven't a future.
Oh, you have, you have. Trust me.
Okay, I'll come.
Tony, your tie. It's old Etonian.
Yes, I promoted myself.
Here are the Wall Street prices, Herr Krog.
Put them on my desk.
Yes, sir.
Müller, I want a full report on the Hamburg office. And all the figures on ACU first thing in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Haller, ringing from France, Herr Krog.
Haller? Haller, are you there?
Yes, I'm here, Eric. I tried to get you before, but the damn lines were out of order.
Yes, Miss Farron got through just before they closed down. It all went well then?
Yes, very well. Goodman and Mascagni will buy ACU heavily in Rome and Paris. The price will certainly hold.
Good. I want you back in Germany as soon as possible.
Yes, I'll be with you at the weekend.
You really think you'll find me a job?
Of course.
course he will.
Look, don't ask him now. I mean, well, not right now. It'd be a bit embarrassing if he didn't.
Don't worry about it, Tony.
I wonder if I might have the privilege of a short interview. I particularly want...
Cat? I missed you.
Good.
People have been bothering me since you've been away. That damn journalist downstairs again.
What's he want?
I don't know.
Erich, this is my brother, Anthony.
Oh. Ferrant?
How do you do?
Did you have a good journey?
Oh, not so dusty.
Not so dusty. I'd forgotten that expression. Well, I'm looking forward to having a long talk with you tomorrow, but this evening, if you'll forgive me, I'm...
Of course, you'll have had a tiring day.
Yes. Loudspeakers.
Loudspeakers?
I can't stand them.
I see.
Whiskey, Tony?
Hmm? No, thanks. I'll be pushing along. Goodbye. I'll see you tomorrow, then.
Yes, tomorrow.
You're a stunner, Kate. I hope he appreciates you.
See you tomorrow.
Bye, dear. Soda, please.
You're at the old place.
Beg your pardon?
Eaton, of course.
Oh, yes.
Name's Minty. Work for a newspaper here.
You're the one.
Sorry?
The one who wanted to see Mr. Crowe.
Well, how on earth did you guess?
I was with him, just now. I'm Kate Farrant's brother, if you know her.
Oh, yes, yes. Oh, yes, I know Kate Farrant, of course. Oh, yes, I know Kate Farrant quite well. So you're her brother. Huh? Oh, well. You're here on holiday?
In a way. But there's a chance I might be offered a place on the firm.
Krogh International? Oh. Enviable, yeah. Very enviable. What sort of a capacity, eh?
Mr. Crowe was tired. He wanted to discuss it tonight. I'm meeting with him tomorrow.
Tired, was he? Yeah. Well, you were certainly quite sharp with me. Yes, really rather short, but... I'd be interested to learn how things go. You know, these intimate little stories sometimes... Well, one picks up a little bit here and a little bit there. I seem to have come out without my card. This ought to do. There'd be a payment, of course, for any information that you may... Nothing very much, but something.
I shouldn't think anyone would be interested.
Oh, you'd be surprised. Anything to do with Krogh is news round here. He's my board and lodging. My only fear is that he'll die first. Patterson would have been before your time, of course.
Who?
Patterson? Chaplin?
Eaton?
You wouldn't remember Chester either, I suppose. Got 6 months for indecent assault.
No, I don't think I...
Who was your housemaster?
Well, he would have been since your time. We called him Stodger.
Curious you don't remember Chester.
Well, I've been out of England now for some years.
Me too. Yes, me too. My mother still lives at Woking. She'd be 86 this year. 86.
Yes, well, I'm very tired myself, Mr. Minty. I've had a long trip.
Wonderful old girl. You'd like her. You're not leaving?
Well, I'm sure I'll be seeing you again.
I could pay you in advance, you know, for any really good story, but it'd have to be exclusive. Once you've joined Krogh International, they'll all be after you. But don't touch them. Don't trust them. I've lived here for 15 years, and I know what I'm talking about. Besides, we British ought to stick together. It's the only way.
Yes, well, goodbye.
Write on one side of the paper only. You look like a schoolmaster marking examination papers.
Your father was a schoolmaster, wasn't he?
I didn't like him. Archie and Tony didn't get along. He was too severe.
Well, fathers often expect too much of their children. It's a great mistake.
You can find something for him, can't you?
Your brother? Yes. He has decent manners anyway. And that's rare today.
Then it just went off bang. The coolie must have dropped the bomb on his own feet. Blew himself to pieces. I must have frightened him when I shouted.
And the minister?
Not a scratch.
Well, I think they should at least have given you a medal.
Well, they did. He got the Order of the Celestial Peacock, second class. My brother's too modest.
Liz, this is Kate. Kate, Liz.
How do you do? Hello.
Liz comes from Coventry. Her father makes bicycles. Isn't that written?
Are you staying long?
Only a few days, I'm afraid.
Hardly long enough to see the place properly.
Only Liz doesn't speak much German yet, so I thought we might...
I'm free all day tomorrow.
Tony, you don't speak any German either.
Well, so much the better. We British ought to stick together. Well, I'll telephone you later.
All right.
I mean, bicycles, Kate. How British can you get? Something about bicycles that, well, I don't know, reassuring things. Part of the English character, one might say. There might even be a job for me there, who knows?
Depending, no doubt, on what progress you make tomorrow.
Don't talk like that. She's a nice girl.
Well, I shouldn't feed her too much of that Joseph Conrad stuff, if I were you.
You mean about the bomb on the minister?
It wasn't true, was it?
Of course it was true. Well, not exactly. Hey, I've won something. Thank you.
Mr. Fallon here to see you, Herr Krogh.
Send him in.
Well, Mr. Krogh, it's good of you to see me.
Yes.
Please, sit down.
A rat. I just won it. In a funfair sort of place. Kate didn't want it.
Won it?
Shooting.
Oh, shooting. I once was invited to Scotland shooting. I didn't go. In fact, I've never shot anything in my life.
Oh, well, blasting away at the poor old birds is not my idea of sport.
But it's useful for meeting people.
I suppose so, yes.
You don't find people difficult?
Depends. Not really.
Your sister doesn't either. And I do.
People are a perpetual problem. They're afraid of me, that's why. You're not, are you?
I haven't any reason to be.
Quite so. Quite so.
The English are different. I admire them for it. The Germans are a race of lickspittles. Lickspittles. And what you're saying?
Quite right, Mr. Grove.
Now, about you. Perhaps something on the social side. Sort of liaison with the publicity. Is that good?
It's funny you should say that. I've already made one or two contacts.
What contacts?
Well, some of the local journalists.
You be careful of them. You be careful of journalists. Very careful. A man in my position has to be very cautious with his dealings with the press. A number of things that I have to do to see that the firm gets the right sort of publicity. Tonight, for example, I have to go to the opera. You fond of music?
Yes. I like a good tune.
You come too. You'll enjoy it. It's the first night. We always go to first nights.
Wagner, is it?
One of the great love stories I've told.
Oh, no, you're thinking of Carmen.
Am I?
Yes, I know this story. It's all about some king or other who sends his best friend to collect his fiancée. Well, there's some mix-up about a drink which is supposed to give people a lech for each other. And they both drink it, you see, and, well, of course it does. Then she has to go back and marry the other fellow, the king. Now, you can't really call that a great love story, can you?
You may be right.
Barrent?
Hmm?
If I fall asleep, you'll have to wake me up. It's very important.
Look, if you find it so dull, why don't we go somewhere else?
It's impossible, I'm afraid. On a first night, one has to be seen. All right, Stein.
Nightclub. You know, something with a bit more go.
It's out of the question, Tony.
He's quite right, Farrand. If I'm not there, God knows what rumours will start.
It's worth the risk, though, isn't it? Come on, Kate, use your influence.
Do you think I should, eh?
All right, yes, you should.
Bravo!
You look happy, Kate. I'm glad we came. This young brother of yours is a desperate fellow. He'll make his miss the opera like that. I'll be in every newspaper tomorrow.
Do you care?
Not a bit.
Is it true you worked on a construction gang when you were in America? Then how did you get into the stock exchange?
My secret.
If I could employ a little magic that would finally destroy this dream that pains me and enchains me, but I can't because I'm mad about the
opera.
Mm.
Yes, there's nothing like a good English tune. Here, how about shaking a leg? You and Kate. Dancing.
Oh, dancing. Shaking a leg.
No, not me. You two. Please, please, enjoy yourself.
Enjoying himself for once in his life. Look at him now.
You will be very successful. And soon, have your own business.
Good evening, Herr Kroger.
Rome.
Mayor.
Please. As long as you don't want a story.
No, Herr Kroger, of course not. I wouldn't dream of intruding on your privacy like that. You know I wouldn't. Besides, Herr Krog, you've forgotten something.
What?
I don't have a newspaper anymore. They took it away from me.
I'm sorry. I couldn't do anything about that. What is it?
It's my son, Herr Krog.
What's the matter? We're not paying him enough?
Of course, Herr Krog, you're very generous. I've had no news from him for 3 days. My daughter-in-law telephoned me. She's worried sick.
Well, there must be some perfectly simple explanation.
I hope so.
Which of my companies does he work for?
He's in Hamburg, Herr Krog, with the ACU.
Well, let me know if I can do anything for you.
Herr Krog.
Very kind. My apologies for interrupting. Good night, Herr Krug.
Good night.
Go on. He will if you ask him.
Erich, Tony says you're to dance.
No, I dance like an elephant.
Come on, Mr. Krog, don't be so bashful.
Please, Evans.
Liz, it's Anthony. We're at this nightclub. Why don't you join us?
Anthony, I wish you'd rung earlier. It's no good now. I'm halfway to bed.
But it's early.
It's past 11.
Well, have lunch with me tomorrow.
I can't. As you didn't ring, I promised I'd have lunch with some friends.
Well, tell you what, have breakfast with me tomorrow. How about that?
Oh, all right. Yes, breakfast then.
Fine. I'll pick you up at 8.
All right.
Cheerio.
Bye.
Nothing.
Tony,
you're getting drunk.
Her face was all bruised.
But why?
I don't know. Well, I never found out. Maybe she was a red or something.
Oh, she'd hear my dad going about them.
Well, he doesn't have girls beaten up there, does he?
I should say not.
People don't behave like that in England, thank God.
No, you're right.
You stick with the old firm. It's safer. Oh, by the way, I bought this for you yesterday. Do you like him?
Oh, yes, he's lovely.
You see, he likes you too. Shall we take him for a walk?
Yes, all right. Freedom for the sexes, don't you?
Yes. But it's different for a man.
Is it? Surely not nowadays.
It's just that some things are right and others are wrong. It's a matter of principle.
A bit old-fashioned, really, aren't you, Tony?
Old-fashioned? Me? Not in the least.
It's only another old procession. They have them all the time in Germany. It's boring.
Oh, I don't know. I like a good parade.
Come on, then. Let's have a look.
There. What's all that supposed to prove?
That doesn't solve any problem.
Have we any problems?
That's a silly question. There's always problems. Haller's coming back this weekend. We must open up Brussels. That's imperative.
If you think it's wise?
This is not a time for wisdom. That's the truth of the matter.
Was it in Coventry?
What?
Your love affair.
No. London. Richmond. Why? Well, it's healthy, isn't it? It's perfectly natural. There doesn't have to be anything emotional about it. Relationships are so limiting.
I don't believe you've ever had a man. I believe you're a virgin. I'm sorry. Look, I said I'm sorry.
What about Hamburg? What about the ACU?
What about it?
They're still selling.
So we've gone by.
There is a limit.
No limit.
But the ACU.
Salzman are buying.
They'll be buying a shell.
ACU will be worth what it is now, and it'll be in the form of shares.
The collateral's worthless.
Exactly.
Is it safe?
Not very.
The Reichsminister arrives tomorrow. What if he guesses?
He won't. Why should he?
How long have we got?
10 days. 2 weeks at the most.
In Richmond.
We went on the river.
If we were in London, I know a place we could go to.
Don't you have any friends here, Tony?
No. Wait a minute. Yes. Come on.
Smile.
From?
Has his son anything to do with it?
If they've taken him in, it's because he's a Jew. He can't tell them anything. Nevertheless, the situation is delicate.
We're not safe.
No. All I have is money and an international organization, and Hitler's not overfond of either of them. If I make a legal move, they're bound to block me. So what's left?
Fraud.
Fraud, that's right.
Ish.
And what do you think all this is? Government by confidence, tricksters. That's what I'm up against. And they're not going to pull me down. I'm just going to take their money. That's all.
Just excuse me into your moment, will you, Irene?
Let me introduce Miss Savage, Mr. Minty.
Oh, yes? I'm so pleased. Do sit down. If you can find anywhere to sit. Really rather embarrassing. I don't do very much entertaining. I'm not here. Will you have some cocoa?
No, thanks, sir. We've already had breakfast. It's just a friendly visit.
Yes, that's what I thought. Yeah, how lucky you were to catch me. I was just leaving for work. You haven't any news for me, I suppose, from Krogh International?
Well, I may have soon. You see, I'm taking up a job with the publicity department.
Publicity? Oh, that is jolly. Are you sure you won't have some cocoa?
No, really.
Cake, pepper, gooseberry, jam?
Have you got a canary?
I did have it. Sang too much and died. I wonder why I want a gooseberry jam. I don't even like gooseberry jam. You'll be in the money then, huh?
Well, I don't know how much cash is involved.
Well, I shouldn't rely on it too much if I were you. Krogh isn't going to go on forever. Trust Minty.
But he's one of the richest men in Europe.
I mean, all said and done, he's like us. The only difference is that people trust him. They lend him money. He's a borrower. Nothing more than that. We can't borrow because we're not trusted. If we could be borrowers, we'd all be crooks. Mind my spider! Please don't touch my spider. Trust can be misplaced. That's all I'm saying. Well, I must be getting along.
I wonder if you mind if we stayed here a bit. We've been walking around all morning.
Oh, and I thought you'd come here for the pleasure of Minty's company. False, false parent. Oh, but please, please, yes, make yourselves quite at home. Stay here. Talk. Nobody comes to see Minty. Oh, thank you very much. And don't worry too much about what I said, Krogh.
Oh, All same, you've got to admit he's got guts.
Yes, yes, that's, I mean, he's not a gentleman. It makes him so difficult. Oh, well. I wonder if you could lend me a mark or two.
Yes, oh.
Not my monthly check, but a change. Oh, thank you.
I think perhaps you should marry me.
A wife, you mean, can't give evidence? Is that true in Germany as well as in England?
There's no danger in Germany. It's England I'm thinking of.
It was good of you not to make love to me.
We have business people.
I shall want a settlement for myself.
Yes, of course.
And something, too, for Tony.
I like Tony. He knows his way around. I'm really rather fond of him, Kate.
But a settlement?
Yes, a settlement.
Anthony would be pleased. There's no one more respectable than Anthony.
Darling Tony, I wish I wasn't leaving tomorrow.
Can't you stay on a bit?
I'm afraid not. Dad would make such a fuss. Why don't you come back home?
I wish I could. But I've got this job here.
Your sister. She's Krogh's mistress, isn't she?
What's wrong with her?
Oh, nothing. Just wish you had a respectable job.
I'm going to be married.
Who to? Krogh? You can't.
Why not?
You're not in love with him.
Aren't I?
Kate, you know you're not.
I'm not in love with anyone, but that's hardly the point. I thought you'd be pleased.
If you're happy, I'm happy too.
Of course I'm happy. It's what I've always wanted. It means we can always be together, the three of us. What's wrong with that?
Yes? Yes, she is. It's for you, it's Krogh.
Hello?
Kate?
Now, I've been thinking, we'll give a party at the villa this weekend. I've already invited the Reichsminister. It might be useful.
Yes, I think it might.
Now, it's a good idea if you go down today and see that the staff are prepared.
May I take Tony down with me?
Yes, of course.
You can pick us up at the villa, Stein.
Yes, madam. Good morning, for a minute.
Good morning. The villa's over there.
What, the building in the trees?
Mm-hmm. I thought you might like to row across.
What, all that way?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Come on, then. Villa? It's a palace. Kate, remember that night in the barn?
When you ran away from school?
And you sent me back again.
Wasn't I right?
Thank you.
won't you send me back now?
Girl, that's who it is. You were happy enough before.
Yes, but I'd only just got here.
Well, exactly. Tony, there's something I think I should tell you.
Look, if it has to do with you and Krogh, I don't want to. It's none of my business.
Listen. Erich won't be staying in Germany very much longer.
I still don't see what that has to do with me.
He's moving. Almost certainly to England.
But his head offices are here in Germany.
He's moving them. And you'll be rather more useful to him in London, won't you, than you could be here. He'll get you in on some very nice little deals. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Yes, I suppose so. But can he do that?
He's doing it.
I'm just going to take their money. That's all.
It's a swindle. An out-and-out swindle. You mean in a couple of weeks' time all his German companies will be worthless?
And all his assets will be in England and America.
The old bastard.
It's very dangerous for him.
I said he had guts.
It mustn't get into the papers.
Better make it worth our while.
Tony, I'm not going to blackmail him. I'm going to marry him.
Don't worry, darling. Mum's the word. But he better not let you down, because if he does, we've got him over a barrel. I think I can trust Erich. I wish I was coming with you.
I wish you were.
Think you'll miss me a bit?
Yeah.
Won't you?
What's the point?
I've been thinking. I will come home. I've made up my mind.
You won't, though.
I'll be there within a week, I promise.
It'd be fun.
A relationship?
I don't care, just for once.
Goodbye. Oh, where shall I meet you?
Coventry High Street. There's a cafe, the Moroccan.
Okay. Bye.
Dan?
Hello, Minty.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
Oh, just picking up the crumbs that fall.
It's interesting. Feel like a drink?
Yeah, I'd like a coffee. I wonder if you've got any cigarettes. I seem to have left mine behind again. I don't know.
I'm checking it all up. Going back to England.
Sooner or later, everyone goes. Only Minty stays.
This time next week, I'll be in good old London.
Yes, I wish I could come with you. The job's a job these days. By the way, I saw one of Krogh's people just now. That man Haller.
I expect he's coming to the party.
Huh?
Krogh's throwing one at the villa.
Well, you might have mentioned it before. Really?
Some big government wallet's been invited, too.
That explains all those comings and goings. Oh, what a pity you're chucking up your job.
How about a farewell present?
I would. I really would, but I haven't got anything just now. Not until next month.
No, I mean for you.
Uh-huh.
A piece of headline news. For nothing.
That's too generous.
Crow's going to marry my sister.
Holy Knut. You don't mean it. That's wonderful.
She doesn't know I'm leaving. Not really. Have another coffee.
No. I'm really getting along. I haven't told anybody else.
It's a secret.
Just so. Splendid.
The Rags Minister. I saw him at the airport. What's he doing here?
He's coming to a party at the villa.
Amongst other things. It's the other things that worry me, Eric. Does he suspect anything?
Of course he does. This government lives on suspicion.
If he finds out that we've been buying our own stocks...
Impossible. We've been too clever for that. Anyway, the old fox hasn't accepted the invitation just out of politeness.
Why then?
Because he wants to show me a little of his hand in the hope that I'll show him a little of mine.
I don't like it, Eric. I don't like it at all. If he finds out what you've really been up to, you'll never get as far as the frontier.
You worry too much, Friedrich.
It's your safety I'm thinking about, Eric.
Like this lying around. I've done bookkeeping, you know. I can add two and two together.
Don't ever mention the name of ACU again. Not to Erich, not to anyone.
Then why did you tell me yesterday what he's up to?
Never mind why. Now I want you to bloody well forget it.
All right, Kate, all right. Anything you say. Anyway, you don't have to worry. I made up my mind. I'm going back to England now.
You've just seen her off, haven't you?
I have to be there a week from today. I've promised.
And what will you do for a job?
Oh, I'll scrounge along somehow.
Aren't you tired of just one job after the other?
Well, this one just isn't my cup of tea.
You've got moral scruples, is that it?
I'm sorry, Kate. There it is.
You need some money, then.
I'll pay you back, of course. Just as soon as I find something.
What I can't understand is why I can never refuse you. I ought to say no. If you stayed here another week, you'd have forgotten that girl.
Yes, maybe I would.
I can't appeal to you like she can. You'd think it's stupid to say you loved me. Or indecent or something.
But I do love you, Kate. You know I do. Jesus!
That's how I love you, Tony.
You almost had my hand off.
Did I? Oh, take the money, Tony, and get out of here. I'm busy. Tony? You'll come to the party tonight, though, won't you?
The party? Oh, you bet. I never miss a good party.
Like this. You like this music?
Mmm, jolly good.
Come on then, let's dance.
That's a shame. Pretty well done, don't you think?
Will you be starting the autumn manoeuvres?
I think next month.
Ah, yes.
See that he's entertained. He likes young people.
Young men or women?
Women. In public.
I say, how about sitting this one out?
I bet you say that to all the girls.
Only the pretty ones.
Drunk to me.
I would be grateful for a little informal chat tomorrow, if you can spare the time.
Of course.
Splendid. Shall we say 11 at Regent headquarters?
Yes.
Sorry, I didn't speak German.
From is the name. From.
Herr Krog. I have to see him. It's really very urgent.
I know, why not? I'm happy, aren't I?
There's a chap out there who wants to see you.
Tell Haller to see what he wants. What's his name?
Oh, yes, sir. From.
Your name, From?
Yes. If Herr Krog could see me.
Herr Krog can't see you. Not now or any time.
But you don't understand. My son's been arrested in Hamburg.
You're bothering him.
He hasn't done anything.
Don't bother him.
Please. Bloody ACU accounts is one thing, but letting an old man like that get beaten up is quite another.
Tony, stop it!
Kate!
Well, I didn't tell them.
But you told Tony, didn't you?
He is my brother.
And Tony told Minty.
How do you know that?
Because Stein saw them talking together at the airport. It doesn't much matter.
going back to England tomorrow anyway. He's in love with someone. Or so he says.
That might not be convenient now.
I can't stop him going.
Well, perhaps I can persuade him to stay.
Could you?
I've got to go. I have to see the Reichsminister.
To learn from me. Now he's playing teacher.
Yes, we're up against it.
No, we're not. First principle of jiu-jitsu. Win by giving way.
Kate, I can't stay here much longer.
There isn't a train until this evening.
Yes, I know, but I...
If it's because of last night, don't worry about it. Everyone's forgotten it.
Forgotten it? Dash it all, Kate.
You mustn't leave. It's too dangerous. It's not his fault. He doesn't understand. We can handle the local journalists, but once he's in England...
We could keep him here.
How?
Does he play poker? A little game of cards. Remember that time in Stockholm? Get him to sign a few IOUs. You'll never be allowed to leave the country if he owes people money.
Unless his sister helps him.
She won't. I'll see to that. Anyway, she doesn't want him to go.
Get him in a game tonight. We'll squeeze him dry.
He may win.
It's very slippery, isn't it?
It always has been.
Has to go with it.
Three sixes. Bad luck. Brilliant.
Your deal, Mr. Farron. Stand behind me, Kate. Bring me luck. Yes, I ought to be leaving soon. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Cross your fingers, twiddle your toes. That's the way the money goes.
You don't play, Miss Farron?
You can join me in the workhouse after this deal.
Oh. This calls for thought. The military art of camouflage, eh? Three.
One. Thank you.
Three.
Dealer takes,
Will the Reich's minister be staying long?
I believe not.
I'm out for the moment. Double.
I'm with you.
Double.
Double.
This will have to be the last hand for me, I'm afraid.
Double.
Double again.
Pass. Double.
The Lord, I bought my tickets.
Bought your tickets?
Otherwise, there'd be no London for yours truly. I'll have to see you.
After tools. Two, three queens.
Straight flush.
It'll take you all night to win that back, huh?
I think I'll get a breath of fresh air.
Well, I'll be able to have a good old blind on this when I get back to London.
Cognac?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Rather.
Nobody will believe you, Tony.
I know. It's a pity, isn't it? It makes the best yarn yet. Well, I better be off. So it's goodbye.
I've hardly seen you.
Well, why didn't you come with me?
How can I?
Well, I'll treat you. I'm pretty flush now. You can't want to stay. Not now.
Tony, I've been here 6 years. I've worked bloody hard.
You're still going to marry him, then? I see. Well, this time I really will write.
Oh, go to hell.
No, thanks. I think I'll walk. Thanks. Cheerio.
Certainly, Herr General, when you finish your game.
No, gentlemen, stay. As long as you like.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Haller left his wallet here.
I see. Well, when he does come in, would you ask him to give me a ring, please? His sister, tell him I must speak to him. Yes, however late.
Thank you.
her to hell. That's the last thing I said to him.
Mr. Haller.
Good morning, Mr. Minty.
Good morning. Oh, yes.
May I come in?
Please.
You know young Tony Farron, don't you?
Slightly, yes.
Have you heard from him lately?
Heard? No, I saw him at the airport a couple of days ago.
Okay, Mr. Minty.
If you like.
This doesn't make any difference.
Doesn't it? Goodbye, Erich.
Evolution assigned men and women different skills.
We'll take a fascinating look at our gender differences Saturday in an A&E special presentation, The Opposite Sex.
And now, the History Channel presents History Sunday, next on A&E.